Hello everyone. Yesterday's match was RCB versus Delhi, played in Dubai. My simple point of view regarding yesterday's match I would like to share with you people. Anyway, it was typical clinical performance by Delhi. Convincingly, they won the match yesterday. You must have seen it. Before we start, I would like to share statistics with you. Rabada is the only bowler who has taken wickets in all the 19 matches which has played recently in IPL. Earlier, this record was with Vinay Kumar. Anyway, coming back to this match, they had a solid start, Delhi. Prithvi Shah played very well, he was totally in attacking mood like Chitty Robo. He scored brilliantly and a solid start with Dhawan, 70 runs of 7 overs. That was the platform laid. And later on, Rishabh also scored well, as well as Sonis, who came in the end. At the strike rate of 200, he scored 53. He is renowned for this in Australia, big boys and all. Nothing new in this. They took the score to a respectable, 195 was a huge score. Like Chahal was looking off colour for RCB. Probably would have been dangerous if he had bowled second. Since he was bowling in the first innings, he was looking off colour, especially Shah was on that mood. Now, Kohli, first blunder he made is he won the toss, he took fielding. And the reason he gave at the time of toss was that yesterday CSK had chased well, so we are going to chase. I mean, you don't go business about this, because yesterday was yesterday. T20 cricket is so fast nowadays. This is a game like EB, power shedding. Like any time it will fluctuate, it will go up, it will come down. You live on the presence. You watch what is happening in the present. Every 10 minutes, match shuffles. I mean, he said that they chased, but you didn't chase. And the fact of the matter is, twice RCB has played in this ground, batted first and won. Delhi played thrice, batted first and they won. Statistics clearly showing, I don't know why he took fielding. And if you have taken fielding, you should have restricted them less than 175. If you can't do, then this is what happened. And normally any T20 game, you need a good start for a chase. And especially when you're chasing 196, you need a solid start, which they never had. Or the top three was gone very quickly. Kohli was the only person who was trying to steady the innings, but it was too late. I mean, Kohli was also on double mind. He had only two choices, either attack or play steadily. He thought, if I attack, if I get out, they will be all out. So let me steady, let me go in the end. That is what his idea would have been, but that is a wrong negative attitude. He is the best batsman in the world. He can hit sixes and gaps and all. He should have gone for the runs. If he's out, so be it. So what? Everyone gets out. Anyway, you lost that match. This was my observation about Delhi. The captaincy was very poor. The moment he lost won the toss, fielding means 50% was gone. So this is on the top three also, gone. And Ashwin and Akshar Patel, they bowled brilliantly. What I have seen is Shreyas Iyer's captaincy. He brought Ashwin and Akshar Patel. He bowled their 7 overs in the first 12 overs itself. That was very key, because he knew there is due factor. It will be difficult to grip the ball in the second innings around 8:30 p.m. So he managed to finish their 7 overs in the first 12 overs itself. And they both bowled brilliantly. You have seen that. And yesterday also I predicted, Devdutt Padikkal was weak against off-spin in the Syed Mushtaq Ali when he was playing Sundar. He took that point. I mean, you would have discussed with the mentor, and they spotted that. And Ashwin came attack. I mean, normally I thought Rabada is going to bowl the third over also, but Ashwin bowled as per the plan. He bowled the same off-spin, and he was caught on the deep mid-wicket. There was only one fielder. It was a brilliant move. And Akshar Patel, yesterday prediction, I said that Amit Mishra, if not fit, they should play Akshar Patel because of his left-arm angle, which he has taken a couple of wickets also. Altogether, they 8 overs, they gave only 42 or 43, less than 6 runs per over. Chasing 196 is brilliant. Sorry. And Rabada. Rabada Nokia. He kept their 5 overs for the slog. Shreyas Iyer. That was also a brilliant move. He knows that they will contend in the end. They bowl brilliantly. And Rabada Nokia, they are at tandem, they are very good, because they both bowl for South Africa. They played a lot together, which other overseas player doesn't have that comfort. That was that factor. They bowled well and they took 6 wickets among them. These fast bowlers couldn't do. Saini, I mean, he tried his best. I am comparing him with Rabada in a couple of years' time down the line, because he has that pace. 145 plus. Initially, go for the pace. Don't go for variation, Go for line and length and go attack the stumps. You will naturally get the wickets. Overall, this was the performance about Delhi, clinical performance. Now, RCB, there is nothing to say except but disappointment. I mean, they have 4 days rest, regroup, and they're going to play our CSK next in Dubai. Let's see how they're going to perform. And often, this is what happens when you field. I mean, the clinical performance, they had no clue at all. Some soft suits dismissal like Moeen Ali, A.B. de Villiers and all. A.B. de Villiers' shot, which he hit in the mid-wicket, he got out. If he had batted for the same shot, would have gone over the rope for a six, because ball was coming very good on the bat. Second inning, ball was keeping low, it took the top edge. These are my brief observation about this match. And RCB deservingly lost that match. Anyway, let them forget this, concentrate on the future. Hope you like this video. If you like, please comment, share, and I will give my review for the coming match in the next.